How much do we really know about the Mass? Let's find out. The word Mass was first adopted as the general term for the Eucharistic sacrifice in the West after the time of Pope Gregory the Great. Now, the early church used a different expression. That expression, breaking of bread, can be found in the book of Acts, chapter 13, verse 2. In the early days of Christianity, we find other terms were used. The Lord's Supper, the sacrifice, the gathering together, the mysteries, and since the time of St. Augustine, the sacrament of the altar. It's a noteworthy fact that the divine institution of the Mass can more readily be established by means of the Old Testament than by means of the New. In fact, following the precedent of many church fathers, and most especially the Council of Trent, much emphasis was placed on the prophetical relation that undoubtedly exists between the offering of bread and wine by Melchizedek and the Last Supper of Jesus. The best and clearest Old Testament prophecy concerning the Mass is undoubtedly that of Malachias, who makes a threatening announcement to the Levite priests in the name of God. He says, "I have no pleasure in you, says the Lord of hosts, and I will not receive a gift of your hand. For from the rising of the sun even to its setting, my name is great among the Gentiles. And in every place there is sacrifice, and there is offered to my name a clean oblation. For my name is great among the Gentiles, says the Lord of hosts." Malachi chapter 1, verse 10 through 11. Now, according to the unanimous interpretation of the fathers of the church, the prophet Malachias here foretells the everlasting sacrifice of the new dispensation. For he declares in this Old Testament reading that these two things will certainly come to pass. The abolition of all Levitical sacrifices and the institution of an entirely new sacrifice. Now, it's easy to show that the sacrifice referred to by Malachias did not signify a sacrifice of his time, but was rather to be a future sacrifice belonging to the age of the Messiah. The passage is proof that the prophet beheld a future event belonging to the Church of Christ. Is this not what we have today within the Holy Catholic Church, an unending sacrifice? As we speak, there is the sacrifice of the Mass taking place throughout the Church and the world in the name of Almighty God. And take note, the prophet states, "There is offered to my name a clean oblation." Could there be a more clean, or should we say, pure oblation than the Lamb of God, his Son Jesus Christ, offered on Catholic altars from the rising of the sun to its setting? As we move into the New Testament, we find Jesus with the Samaritan woman at Jacob's well, where Jesus himself makes a prophetic reference to the Mass when in John chapter 4, verse 21, Jesus says, "Woman, believe me, that the hour comes when you shall neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem adore the Father. But the hour comes, and now is here, when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth." Jesus seems to refer to a future sacrifice of praise, which would not be confined in its liturgy to the city of Jerusalem, as it had been during the time of Christ, but would engulf the whole world. We also see Hebrews chapter 13, verse 10, where it is said, "We have an altar whereof they have no power to eat, who serve the tabernacle." Since St. Paul makes a clear distinction between the Jewish sacrifice, those who serve the tabernacle, and Christian altar, it is obvious Paul refers to a new sacrifice, the sacrifice of the Mass. The main testimony of the New Testament lies in the account of the institution of the Eucharist, and most clearly in the words of consecration spoken over the chalice. We Catholics might be familiar with the following scripture verses. Matthew chapter 26, verse 28. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which shall be shed for many unto remission of sins. Mark 14, verse 24. This is my blood of the New Testament, which shall be shed for many. Luke 22, verse 20. This is the chalice, the New Testament in my blood, which shall be shed for you. 1 Corinthians 11, 25. This chalice is the New Testament in my blood. Sound familiar? From the Old Testament to the New Testament, we find evidence of the Mass. How much do we really know about the holy sacrifice of the Mass? For more information on the holy sacrifice of the Mass and other Catholic topics, please visit the New Advent Catholic Encyclopedia website. Great information, solid information on all Catholic issues.